Calvin Gaston at Clutchburg State Fieldhouse. It's the 25th day of February 2017, a Saturday afternoon. Game time is 3 o'clock. Third game of the day, so they're running a little bit behind. The Beekmantown Eagles, number 6 ranked against the number 2 ranked Northeastern Clinton Central School Cougars coming at you right here, right now. On viewer-supported local television. Not sure who Beekmantown beat to upset to get here. I'm assuming maybe it was Cernak, but I do not know that. There's Kenny Mabry with the basket. So when we get that Cernak girl to sit down, we'll be all set. McLeod to Hollister, back to McLeod. Who is the defending Class B champions? High school number one seed this year. Hollister hits to make it 3-3. Mabry will bring it into the forecourt. Over to Wilson. And basket by Evan Brunell. Duffy, off the shot by Beasley. 5-3, Beekmantown leading here in the early going. Rebounded by Milanese. Maybe we'll bring it up. George Dyer, Jamie LaBarge, and Keith Revenue are your officials. Temperature was 60 degrees when I set my vehicle off 3.5 hours ago. Actually, it was 4 hours ago. Mighty warm day here, record-setting temperatures in the forecast, and we're already almost there when we shut our car off. So it's supposed to be a record, all-time record for the month of February, not just February 25th. He goes ball. 30 is Hurwitz. Rebounded by Mossy. Now we have a foul on the Eagles. First foul of the game. Thank Norm Bono and Kevin Hicks for renewing their viewer support today. This is viewer-supported local television, and referee Jamie LaBarge. We've got a contribution in the mail from the Altona Fire Department, so we appreciate their support yet also. Who we got here? 35. Oh, you know, oh, that's Chris Arzola. He's originally number 1, but to be number 35, maybe for out of his uniform at home, who knows. Eagles threw it away in an unforced turnover. Cougars brought their championship cheerleaders with them today. They'll probably be out on the floor when time allows. So a week from today, while the boys sectional championships are being decided. The cheerleaders will be at their state competition. It's Duffy to make it 5-5. 5-0-5 to go in the first. Winner faces Peru and Plattsburgh winner. Cougars almost had the ball. Wilson giving chase out there. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Eagles will keep it. Wilson will inbound it. Followed by Hurwitz. Looks like he just came off the hockey team. Holy! They got a guy in the clock who can knows how to put the fouls on the scoreboard. They don't keep them up there, but at least they're putting them up there. In all the girls' games, they didn't do that. And I don't hear the PA system very well over on the side. Azola. Azola. He throws it in for a 7-5 Eagle lead. We're 4 minutes, so we're halfway into the first half. First quarter. Quarter of the way into the first half. Funny how that works. Timeout for the Cougars. 3:41 on the clock. 7-5 the score. Hollister inbound. Into McLeod. Over to Beasley. Cougars weren't fully in tune with that shot clock. So the buzzer sounded a sour note. Off the rim. Rebound on the cloud. Whoop. Beasley, I mean. Here goes Riker going. Rebounded by Mossy. Beasley into the forecourt. Hollis is shot blocked by Brunel. .236 to go in the first. Beekmantown up by two, looking for the upset win. They already have one upset in their playoff. Out, so why not another one, they're saying. Yeah. 3 seconds, I would assume. The crowd will race it into the forecourt. Beasley. The crowd throws it up as he's going to the floor. And we got here another sub in. It's number two, is it? Christian Mara. Wait a minute. On a record update, he's heading for cover here. He's going. He wants more of those mats. We'll send Nick Wilson to the line. Mossy's first. Team first. Wilson. Makes it 8-5. Keegan Munson is in, number 32. I'll make it 9-5, Beekmantown. Beasley, McLeod over to stretch his fingertips just enough to grab that one. Hollister, jumper from the baseline. Rebounded by Wilson. Stolen away by Hollister. Beasley shot, no. What's the call? Push. Push on Wilson. Will be a second? Oh, no, it's first. First. Crowd comes deep for Duffy. Under a minute to go in the first quarter. Wilson lays it in for a 6-point lead. 11-5, Beekmantown with 49 to go in the first. Hollister, McLeod, back to Hollister. Beasley. Into the full court. Duffy hands off. In and out. And a shot by McLeod. Munson with the rebound. Wilson brings it up. Double dribble call. In the first. Wow. Into the stands, souvenir for a lucky fan. Whoop, somebody tripped him. Hollister into McLeod. 20 seconds to go in the quarter. It is down by 6, they'll be content with the last shot. Off these ladies. Gray ball. 4.4 to go. Eagles. So far it looks like they want this more than the Cougars, I think. Cougars playing number 16. They have just come in a little flat. Blocked by Hollister. End of the period. It's 11-5, Beekmantown after one here on viewer-supported local television hometown field. Scores 11-5, Beekmantown. Here's a little note from the time they played at Northeastern. 18-5 Cougars at the end of the first quarter. I'll try to explain why the Cougar boys came out thinking that she's going to be a little cakewalk, but the Eagles have shown them no, they come to play. A little back on Mossy. So his second foul. Oh, he didn't travel. He was on his way down, but he hadn't traveled and he got rid of it. That's a travel. This is the press. Oh, no reach. Munson. Well, if Beekmantown is looking for an example of a number 6 seed winning the title, they have to look no further than the Shazy girls soccer team. They're ranked number 6 in the playoffs, and they finished number 1. Third foul on Massey. He's going to take a seat, and I bet you Timmons will be in for him. Basket by Arzola. Yep, Jordan Timmons. 12-5 Eagles. Duffy. Timmons. Yep, I'm not sure what happened to Timmons. He was down on the floor for a moment. Take my hands off of the camera. The camera had a mind of its own there. Took my hands off for a second. But thought it saw a squirrel, I guess. I was looking up at the rafters. Timeout on the floor. It's 12-5. We got 6:51 to go and a half. Right in the hands of Duffy. Give it to McLeod, should be easy too, and it is. 12-7. Mara up to Wilson. Over to Arzola. Anthony Milanese in the four is back in, or in. He started his back in. Hollister, he draws the foul. Wilson, his second. Mabry in, and Willett's back in. 12-8, 6:15 on the clock. Changing gears. Great job by Hollister. Riley Hollister. My sister is playing in Canton today. In the youth traveling team. It's a one-point game. Hollister's first foul. Inbounded by Mabry for Hurwitz. Field goal in the second quarter for Beekmantown. They now lead 14-11. Beasley pulls up for a jumper off the rim. Good follow by Hollister. Maybe we'll bring it up. Shot. There's a good one. And we got. Now on Brunel, I guess. His first. 4.5 in the first half. 3-pointer would tie it for the Cougars. They trailed by six coming in to the second quarter. They trailed by three. Goes over the top of the backboard. .402 to go, second quarter, 14-11. Three-pointer would give Beekmantown back to a six-point advantage. Arzola, hands off. Wasn't in that game against Northeastern. Too strong. Usually keeps, the crowd keeps it alive, gives it to Hollister. Wilson back in, replacing Milanese. 3:09 on the clock. Eagles up by five, 16-11. Willits bringing it up. Probably a foul on Beasley. Eagles are up by five, 1:03 to go in the second. I'm sure he's trying to keep track of them over there. One minute left in the second quarter. Willits keeps it. Dr. Wilson. Oh, shot rolled halfway down, came out. Jump ball call. Forty seconds to go. He's ready. Over to McLeod. In the paint. Rolls the rim. Munson clears the rebound. 23 seconds. Eagles will probably look for the last shot. Mabry drives the paint. And Hollis the rebound. They lost it on the dribbles. They have to regain it, and he's fouled. 8.9 on the clock. Settles, it's a very low scoring 18-15 lead for Beekmantown over Northeastern at the half here on viewer supported local television, hometown cable. Let's get that floor swept there, young Mr. Yang.
At least for now.
Let the record show that the Cougar cheerleaders have not been out on the floor at all in today's game. I've not been ignoring them. They've cheered from the stands, but not on the floor. Eagles ball, they lead by three. Looking back to that game at Northeastern, it was 39-16 at the half. Cougars were leading by 23. They led by 28 after three, and not sure what the final was. I didn't mark that down. Beekmantown learned a little bit from that one, and the Cougars, as I said, probably thought they could relax after enjoying that contest, as I'm sure they did when you were 39-16 at the halftime. You enjoy it more than the team with the 16. But Beekmantown has come to play. They've got 18 at the half, and the Cougars only 15. Wilson, oh, kick. Kick by Mossy, what the heck? Why not? Mabry bringing it into the fourth quarter. Push on the Cougars. McLeod's first foul. Wilson will inbound. Into Mabry. Take it away. Beasley comes out of the crowd with it. Finds McLeod. Hollister pulls up for the jumper. And Duffy gets the rebound. McLeod to Hollister for three. No. The rebound burn out. 6:33 to go, third quarter. Old extra vittles coming here. Enjoy a feast here in the stands. Mabry, no. Wilson throws it in from the corner. Nick Wilson makes it 21-15, back to that 6-point Beekmantown lead. Hollister tied up. It's Tomasi in the high post. Beasley will shoot. Fouls on Brunell, his second. Another one. 21-16. And it's them both. With a 21-17. Ozola. Off by Mossy. Here comes McLeod. McLeod keeps it and lays it in. Nice shot by Michael McLeod. Mabry. Gives it to Wilson. Wilson guarded by Beasley with 10 seconds. 10 seconds, but the clock said 26. The shot clock said 9 seconds. But Keith Revedu was counting. He counted 10. Cougars can tie it, break the lead. Hollister put the Cougars up for the first time in the game. 22-21. Now the Eagles have got to keep their composure. Playing well, they can't lose their composure because the Cougars have gotten back in the flow of things. Mabry, the three, no, rebounded. Beasley to McLeod, to Hollister, across the basket. Timeout, Beekmantown, Cougars trailing by three, coming in now, lead by three with 4:29 showing in the third. So, see if the Eagles can regroup. Herbert, not that Herbert, that's Arzola. The basket by Brunell. 24-23, off the toe, up the side of the foot of Duffy. Eagles take full advantage of it. And a three-pointer by Wilson. And we're going to have a warning right here. We're going to have a warning. Ozola touching that ball after the Eagles scored. He knocked it way away from the basket. That ball belongs to the other team. Next time, it's a technical. 2-point lead, Beekmantown, 4:06 on the clock. Beasley to Duffy, McLeod. Beasley. To Duffy, puts in the elbow, and rebounded by Brunell. Nope, excuse me, Wilson. He goes up by two. Hoping they regain a little more on that lead. 14 on the shot clock. Wilson for three. It's a friendly bounce. And his team is back up by five. So the Cougar lead is short-lived. And Rob Guerin wants to talk to his team. No basket. And a coin on the floor over to our left. Rebound Brunel, we have a foul on the Cougars. There you go, right there is a coin that rolled out on the floor. There it is. Hopefully nobody will slide on it. Mabry in and out. Seven-point lead, Beekmantown. Timeout works for Beekmantown. Eagles had momentum. Eagles called the timeout. And they got the big mole back. 2:04 to go, third quarter. Out to Duffy. Beasley from 17, nope. Zola brings it up. Duffy wasn't expecting that. Hollister for three. Air ball. Ralph Wilson. 1:22 on the clock. Third quarter. Beekmantown up by 7. Inbound to Hollister. Block. Mabry. Off the rim. Rebound Mossy. McLeod will bring it up. First. Cloud shooting 2. Missed them both. We're now with the rebound. The ball. Offensive foul. Probably on Arzola. His first. Crowd. Back to Beasley. Telegraphing his passes. I don't know why Beasley is so reluctant to bring that into the forecourt. Telegraphed that pass. I could have stole that one. Beasley into the forecourt. Over to Duffy for 3. Beasley follows. Answers up the jumper. 31-26. We're down to 18 seconds in the third. Roll Johnson spins, throws it up and in, got the basket. Foul will be on Beasley. Fouls on McLeod. All right, I didn't see that one. Foul on McLeod. The second. Up by 7, he can make it 8. He does. 15.3. Sub in to get Hurwitz back in, replacing Wilson. 15.3 to go. Brown to Hollister. Hollister forces it in. And time runs out. 34-28. Eagles leading the Cougars by 6 after 3 here on viewer supported hometown cable. With all the excitement, I forgot to switch batteries. We've got 9 minutes left on this one, so hopefully we'll get a timeout before it runs out. And we lost it. So we'll take it back. We're now with a foul, his third. 34-28 Eagles after 3 at Northeastern, those 53-25 Cougars, so 180 degree turnaround. Duffy with the ball. The Cougars turn it over. And the Mabry. They just take it away. McLeod throws it up short. Duffy comes out with it. Beasley. McLeod will go to the line. Got Wilson coming back in. Foul was on Mabry, his third. Crowd shooting 2. We can make it a 4-point game with this one. 7:01 left. Timeout Cougars, 6:47 to go, they trail by 5. Hollister in from the crowd, and we put a new battery in, so we're all set. Right in the hands of Munson. He tells his grandkids about it, he'll say, boy, I'm out of nowhere to grab that one. The crowd picks up his third foul. The Yangbo is here. Selling programs. $3 each. Can't go wrong. Thank you. Mabry now. Munson steps with it and puts it in. Egan Munson. Oh, 36-29, under six to go. Mabry picks up his fourth foul. Duffy for three, no. In the hands of Wilson. Mabry into the forecourt. Munson. Off Milanese, I guess they thought otherwise. Point Eagle lead, time ticking down to 5:33. Cloud back to Beasley. Air ball. With the foul, second. It'll be a 1-1 for the Cougars. And we got Brunell back in. 5:25 to go. Beasley shooting a 1-1. We've got Hurwitz coming in. He's going to replace Munson. The front of the 1-1, 36-30, we can make it a 5-point game. And Wilson tried to keep it in bounds and danced a little stutter step onto the out of bounds line. The Cougars will get it back, a break there for Northeastern. To a three-point game, 36-33, Beekmantown. Under five to go. Beasley kept it alive. McLeod brings it up. Back to Beasley for three, no. Yes, for three, no. And off to Hollister. Hollister and Mossy fighting for the same ball. 4:43 to go. Point lead. 4-4 left in the game. McLeod, fadeaway. 1,000. Nice shot by Michael McLeod. 38-35, Beekmantown. 3:47 to go. Section 7. Class B semifinal. Winner advances. Loser hangs him up for the season. Duffy. He lays it in. It's a 1-point game. 38-37. 3:12 left in the ball game. Mabry over to Hurwitz. Wilson off McLeod. 16 on the shot clock. Timeout on the floor. Eagle ball. Arzola inbounds. Cougars take it away. McLeod races it up the floor. Under three left in the game. Hollister. Good Duffy. McLeod to Duffy for three. No. Rebounded Brunel. 38-37 Beekmantown, 2:26 left in the game. Winner faces the winner of Peru and Plattsburgh in the game yet to be played. Duffy knocks it loose. McLeod comes up with it. What? What was that? I didn't see it. George Dyer saw something I didn't. His job to do this. And whatever happened, I didn't see it. Foul picks up his fourth foul. Mabry. Wilson. 17 on the shot clock. Brunel, this is off, scores over, it's out of bounds. Souvenir for a lucky fan. .142 to go in a 1-point ball game. Hollister. Beasley, left in the crowd. .124 to go. Left foul. Hollister, now second effort. Let's put the Cougars up 39-38. We've got 1:10 to go. The lead is Payne Pan. This is Mabry. Wilson, back to Mabry. 14 on the shot clock. Wilson for three, no. Rebound, Beasley. 40 seconds. Cougar, timeout. 39.2, 31 on the shot clock. 39-38 on the scoreboard. If I'm the Eagles, I will not foul to stop that clock. There's an 8-second difference in the game clock and the shot clock. We're only down by one. No problem. Oh, 33.4. Timeout. Well, the Eagles hold it for the last shot of the game. On the last shot. If you're watching at home, place your bets now. There's different thoughts on who you want to be right here. The team with the ball or the team with the 1-point lead. Low scoring game like this, I want to be the team with the lead. Wilson will inbound. Shot clock is off. To Mabry. Eagle. 3 and a half to go. Cougars ball. And the Eagles have a little choice but to foul. They foul Beasley. They shoot a 1-1. It's the 18th foul on Beekmantown. You can make them both. It'll be a 3-point game. If he misses the first one, the Eagles have a chance to rebound. Two-point game. The basket here would put the pressure on Beekmantown, forcing to take a three-pointer to tie it. Eagles rebound. Two-point ball game. 15 seconds to go. Wilson. 10 seconds. Dyer saw a foul, shooting two to tie. 4.3 on the clock. As Mossy's fourth foul. Munson in. Cougar timeout. Now you can't deliberately miss this because you got to hit that rim. You're putting Munson in there to get a rebound. Eagles don't really want to get that one extra point, but if they miss, the clock starts, so I guess if all things considered, you want to get that point and hope for a steal. Rosolo with his second shot. If he misses, they're hoping that one of the big guys will tip it in. Deliberately missed. Munson gets the rebound. Two putback, and it didn't fall. So the Cougars come from behind and hang on for a 40-38 victory. Eagles had two putbacks, and neither one of them would fall. So that's the way it was. Section 7, Class B, semifinal play, Northeastern Sweatin, 40-38 victors over the Beekmantown Eagles. You've been watching viewer-supported local television, Hometown Cable. Win, lose, or draw, TV will be of your support. Hometown Cable, thank you for watching.